Co-founder and CEO of Toothpick. Alvin Nelson, please.
Hi, I'm Balbinder Singh from Toothpay, and Toothpay has a product. It's basically a mobile financial solution, and our target market is the banks and financial institutions, and we help the banks and FIs to enable their mobile channel, very specific. Now, does it make a business sense? It costs a bank virtually $4 to service a customer via a branch channel, and on the other end of the spectrum, it cost a bank something like 8 cents to service the same customer via the mobile channel. So obviously it makes business sense. Now, what are the issues which the banks are facing? First and foremost, there's no universal or one size fits all solution. You have different types of operating systems, you have different devices, and so forth. And to compound matters, there's also the security. And if you look at the trends which is happening lately, as the processor of the smartphone increases, so does the virus and malware attack. Just a couple of months ago, probably about 9 months ago, 250,000 phones in China were hacked at one go. And the guys, they actually let the customers to download certain apps over a period of 6 months. So this is a profound effect. And online mobile banking, hardest hit by cyber criminals last year. And Moore's Law, as we know, as I just mentioned. Now, the other challenge is, as much as we talk about smartphones, etc., the ground reality is that there's a limited numbers of smartphone penetration. And as much as there's a smartphone, let's drill in detail. For example, in Malaysia, the smartphone penetration is 63%, but only 30% have data services. So they have a smartphone, which is not very smart. Okay. Now, what we provide, Toothpay has a solution. It's basically a very thin overlay chip. Okay, so what we have is basically an overlay chip, and we try to make it as idiot-proof as possible. When a customer comes to the bank officer just have to mention this thing. Can you give me your SIM card? The customer provides the SIM card to the bank officer. There's an epoxy at the bottom. The bank officer takes out the epoxy, the lid, and put on top of the SIM and mentions to the customer, can you insert back your SIM into your phone? That's it. And then the customer switch on, and guess what? Magic happens. There's an icon of the bank on the phone, and from there he can do whatever transaction. The only thing the customer has to do, he has to activate. How's the procedure? It depends on the bank. We enable the banks to do whatever procedure through ATM or internet banking or even a paper. As simple as that. Now, what is so great about our solution? First and foremost, it's user-friendly. A very subjective word, user-friendly. Everybody says user-friendly. For us, user-friendly means it works identically on every phone. From the Nokias and Samsungs and Apples in the world to the cheap $20 phone from China. The only difference is that the look and feel. On iPhone, it looks sexy. On other phone, it might not look sexy. Okay, doesn't matter. And whereas the other procedures, how you interact, etc., it's identical on all the phones. So can you imagine on the call center, when you have a problem, you just have to explain in a brief manner. The other thing, it's device independent, as I mentioned, from the most expensive to the cheap $20 phone. It's telco independent, and now the bank doesn't need to get a permission from the telcos. They can enable the solution whenever and however they want. It's access independent. Now the onus is on the bank to decide which mode of communication do they want to communicate using SMS or USSD, etc. No internet is required, so you can even go back to your legacy phones. Secure transaction. With our solution, basically we encrypt from the phone right down to the bank's data center, because we have our software residing in each and every bank's data center. We don't keep anything with us. So it's encrypted all the way. So even if there's a malware attack or virus attack on the phone, it doesn't interact with our solution. It's virtually independent. It's cost effective. Marketing talk. Okay. Obviously. Now, business model. Are we running a charity? Obviously, no. So how are you making money? First and foremost, we have a one-time implementation fees with the bank. And then we have recurring monthly for the duration of our contracts. All our customers until now, we have on average, we have done a 3 years contract. So there's a subscription fees and the transaction monthly fees with the banks. And there's also the cost of this overlay. Deployment, we have a couple of deployment. We have already running in Malaysia, banks in Malaysia, Thailand and Indonesia. We have proof of concept in Cambodia. Going forward, it's in Myanmar and Bangladesh. And we have actually got no objection letters from the central banks of each and every country. And an overview, 600,000 registered users out to today, tested on thousands of phones. And most important is, until today, they have millions of transactions made.
Thank you, Belvinda. Thank you, judges.